Evet, katı kontrol. Leodel'le daha iyi.
I'm your buddy. I'm your buddy now. Is that right? I'm just a buddy.
Yeah.
And Joy's your boyfriend.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Is that the hierarchy?
Yes. He is my boyfriend.
Okay. Let me catch the video.
Okay, let's sit comfortably and easily in any cross-legged position. And another golden rule is a heavy smile on your face. Enjoy doing the posture, okay? It's in the end of the day, you have done enough work, so have a little smile, relax your facial muscles, okay? Have your hands on your knees, palms facing up. Now you guys can mute yourself so that if any noise happening in the home, we are not bothered by that. I again say, if anybody can turn on their camera, please turn it on. It will be good to see some postures, how you're doing, if I need to do some correction. I have put everybody in a gallery mode so I can see everybody. Okay, let's sit comfortably and easily. Palms on your knees, palms facing up. Spine straight, shoulders relaxed. Pull your navel in. Keep your eyes closed. Take a deep breath in And let it go. Another breath in. And exhale. We'll start our practice by chanting Om 3 times. So take a deep breath in for Om. Keeping your eyes closed, observe the vibrations of the sound Om. Take a moment to let go everything, whatever you were doing before, and bring yourself to the present moment right here. Focus on your breath, incoming and outgoing through your nostrils. Take a deep breath in. Expand your belly. You can put your right hand on your navel and keep expanding your belly like a balloon. Expand it in all directions. And when you cannot take any more, hold it for a breath and gently breathe out. Pull your navel in all the way to spine. This is abdominal breath. Take another deep breath in and expand your belly. Feel your right hand coming up. And gently breathe out. Now we will continue to our chest. Take a deep breath in, expand your belly. At the same time, breathe into your lungs. You can put your left hand on your chest and expand your chest. Breathe a little more. You'll feel your collarbone is rising up. And when you cannot breathe anymore, hold it and gently breathe out. Relax your shoulders, relax your chest, and pull your navel in all the way to spine. Let's do a few rounds. Take a deep breath in. Expand your belly. Breathe into your lungs. Expand your chest. Breathe into your throat. Feel your collarbone rising up. And gently breathe out. Let's do two more rounds at your own pace. So this is called full yogic breath. This is utilizing the full capacity of our lungs. Keep breathing in, expanding your belly, expanding your lungs. And breathe out. And with a smile on your face, let's do one more round. Take a deep breath in. And gently breathe out. Now gently open your eyes. You can turn your hands facing down on your knees. And let's rock your body side to side. And this time lift your legs up because you want to open our hips. And gently come to the center. Now see if you can bring your right hand on the right side and left hand up and keeping your left knee down. Stretch towards the right side. And let's do the other side. Feel the difference in both of the sides. One side might, you may go a little bit deeper in the stretch. Other side, it may be tighter. And change. And one more time, left side. And gently relax your hands. Now keep your hands, palms facing down on your knees, elbow straight, tuck your navel in, spine straight. Breathe in, bring your head back. Breathing out, bend forward, and we'll do full body rotation. Breathing out to the right, breathing in to the right and up, breathing out left and down. Bend from your hips. Rotation is from your hips, not just the neck. The whole upper body is rotating. And after finishing this round, let's reverse the direction. Breathing in to left and up. Breathing out right and down. And relax. Now let's bring our right leg into our hands, foot onto the elbow and left elbow, and wrap your right hand around your leg. If you cannot hold it like this, it's okay. You can hold your feet like this, okay? So just do what you can do. And now imagine there's a baby you are holding. Can people mute, please? And then you're rocking the baby. Baby wants to be rocked, held in the mother's arm, and rock the baby a little wider. He's crying. You wide, you rock it little bit wider, as wide, and bring it little up. Kiss your baby. You must be feeling on your right hip. And gently bring your leg on the left groin, near the left hip. Kind of a half lotus, right? Breathing in, bring your hands up. Pull your navel in, straighten your spine. Breathing out, bend from your hips. Look forward. Pull yourself forward, strengthen your spine, lengthen your spine. Just go halfway and drop your hands wherever they go onto the floor. See if you can slide your hands a little bit more. And bend forward. When you cannot bend anymore, just drop your head towards the floor and feel the stretch. Keep breathing here and enjoy the posture with a smile on your face. No need to struggle. If your body is not allowing to bend you forward, that's fine. Just stay where you are. Gently sliding your hands back on the floor, come up. Now let's relax your right leg and bend your right leg like this. Like you're sitting like this, right? Now bring your left hand behind your hips. Breathing in, right hand up. And bring it outside of the right leg and wrap your hand around. Okay, now bring your left hand up and see if you can bring it behind and hold both of the legs. If you cannot, that's fine. Just do what you can. If you have a dupatta or towel, you can use that so that you can hold the towel with both of the hands. And now look up. And gently relax your hands and relax your leg. Let's do the other side. Rock the baby on the other side. See if you can bring your leg a little bit higher and you can rock it wider. and gently put your leg onto your right side of your groin. Feel the difference in this side. Maybe this my hip, this side is tighter than my right hip. Now sit straight, pull your navel in, breathe in, bring your hands up. And breathing out, look forward, lengthen your spine, bend from your hips. Don't go all the way to floor yet. Keep looking forward. And when you feel you cannot bend anymore, drop your hands right in front of you. Look forward. See if you can slide your hand a little bit more forward. And then if you cannot do, just drop your head, relax your neck, relax in the posture. Keep breathing. And gently slide your hands a little bit towards you and come up. Now let's bring your leg, bend your left leg and sit straight with the support of your hand. Right hand behind your back. Breathing in, left hand up and wrap it around your left leg. Breathing in, right hand up and behind your. So I'll show you from the back so that you can see. So left hand up around the leg, right hand around the back and see if you can hold your hand. So here, if you cannot hold your hands, you can have a towel in both of the hands and hold it so that you can hold it and then have a stretch and straighten your spine and look forward or up. Keep breathing. Hold the posture for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And gently come out of the posture. Everybody doing good? Okay, now let's bring our legs forward in front of you. Toes pointing towards you. These toes are pointing towards you. We'll do the forward fold. Breathing in, bring your hands up. Pull your hands up like somebody is pulling you from the top. Pull your navel in, breathing out. Look forward, bring your hands forward like somebody is pulling you again. Lengthen your spine, bend from your hips. Now here you just drop your hands wherever it goes and look forward. Just stay here right now in this posture. So this is good for your legs also and for your hips also. Breathe in, bring your hands up. We'll do one more time. We'll go a little bit deeper. People who have a little bit back issue or anything, please stay in the posture before, okay? Breathing out, bring your hands forward. Look forward like you're pushing a ball in front of you. And when you cannot do anymore, drop your hands. See if you can bend a little bit more. Pull your navel in and drop your hands. Sorry, drop your head toward the knee. And keep breathing. Breathing in, let go of your hands. Gently and very slowly come up. And relax your hands. Now we will do a variation in this. Bend your right leg. Bring it in a half lotus position on the left groin area. Okay? Very close to your hip joint, as close as you can. Breathe in, bring your hands up, straighten your spine. Breathing out, look at your left toe. Bend forward from your hips. Keep looking forward. Lengthen your spine. Just do as much as you can. It's okay if you just go here, okay? And then wherever you go, drop your hands. Look forward still. Lengthen your spine. And then you can lower your head down so that your neck is relaxed. Please, please don't stretch yourself. Don't try to touch your toes. It's okay if your hand just goes till your knees. You're still getting the benefit. Breathing in, bring your hands up gently and let go of your hands. Release your right leg and shake your legs. Now let's do the other side. Bend your left leg, bring it onto the right hip joint, okay? As close to the hip joint you can, okay? And actually you can, with the help of your palm, you can rock your knee. That will loosen up your hips. We forgot on the other side. I remembered because this hip is tighter for me. Now pull your toe towards your face. Straighten your spine. You can do like this with the support of your hands. Straighten your spine. It's very important to take care of your back. Breathing in, bring your hands up towards the ceiling. Breathing out, bend forward from your hips. Keep looking forward. Looking forward, lengthen your spine. Imagine you're pushing a wall in front of you. And when you cannot push anymore, drop your hands wherever it goes. On your leg, wherever. And see if you can go a little bit more. And if you cannot, just drop your head towards the knee. It's not important you touch your toes or your head touches the knee. You're getting the stretch. Whatever your body needs right now. Breathing in, bring your hands up. And relax your hands. And shake your hand, shake your legs. Now let's bring our sole of the feet together in a butterfly pose. And clasp your fingers together and put it under your feet. And rock your wings. Happy, smiley butterfly. Bring it a little bit closer, go closer, then down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Now let's stop rocking and straighten your spine. Breathe in, bring your head back. Breathing out, look forward. Bend forward. Push your thighs with your hands down towards the floor. Just do as much as you can. It's a great hip opener, but it takes time. And gently and very slowly come up, relax your hands, and open your legs wide. Breathing in, bring your hands up. Breathing out, bend forward, bring your hands onto the floor. And look forward, have your back straight. Look forward. See if you can slide your hands a little bit more. And bring it up. We'll do a couple more. Breathe in, breathing out. Bend forward, look forward. Lengthen your spine. Bend from your hips, pull your navel in. Breathing in, bring your hands up. Breathing out, one more time. Bend forward. See if you can go a little bit further this time. And this time, let's drop your head towards your navel and relax your neck and enjoy the posture. You'll stay here for 10, 9, 8, 7,
सिक्स फाइव फोर थ्री टू एंड वन. जेंटली स्लाइड योर हैंड्स ऑन टू द फ्लोर एंड ईच वर्टेब्रा बाय वर्टेब्रा कम बैक. Now let's bend your right leg and put it under against the inner thigh, left inner thigh. Okay. Now slide your left hand towards the left leg, keeping your chest open. So you should not bend like this. Okay. So just be aware. It's okay. You go a little less, but have your chest open. Breathing in, right hand up. Look towards the right hand. Breathing out, bring your right hand towards your left foot, wherever you can reach. And keep looking towards the ceiling. Keep opening your chest. Make sure your right knee is on the floor. Everybody, please mute. There is some noise coming. Breathing in, bring your right hand up and relax. Now let's bend your left. Divakar, can you mute yourself, please? Now we were in the V position. Bend your left leg and put it against your right thigh and sit straight. You can always take the support of your hand, sit straight. Breathing in, bring your hands up and turn towards your right side. Actually, we were doing the other way, okay? So bring your hands down, slide your right hand on the right leg and open your chest. Now breathing in, left hand up, and bring it towards your right foot. Keep opening your chest. And breathing in, gently come up. Relax your hands. Now let's come to the tabletop position. Your knees are underneath your shoulders. Your feet are underneath your hips. And they are a little bit wide apart, right? And we will do some hip openers. So let's start from the left side. Breathe in, bring your left leg up and down. Up and down. And keep looking forward. So bring it up as high as you can. And relax. Let's do on the right side. Breathing in, bring your right leg up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Two more times. And down. Now join your big toes in the back and bring your hands forward. Push your hips back. And come to the child pose. So keep stretching your hands forward and keep pushing your hips back. Okay? In opposite direction. So it's lengthening your spine also. So it's a very good posture for your spine as well. And at the same time, for your hips. Now gently come up in the tabletop, tuck your feet. You'll go to the downward facing dog. Breathing in and breathe out. Bring your knees up. Push your heels towards the floor. Pull your navel in and push your chest towards the thighs and hips pointing towards the ceiling. Both of the legs are straight. Breathe in, bring your right leg up in the air and bring the right leg in between of the hands. and bring the left knee on the mat. Now bring your both of the hands towards the knee and bring the both of the hands to your hips and push your pelvic forward, push your hips forward and look back a little bit. Breathing in, bring your hands on the side and twist your upper body towards the right side. And bring your hands to the center again. Now bring your hands to the floor. Now keep your leg outside of the right foot. Bring your leg outside of the right foot. If you want, you can bring the left knee away from the floor. So that will be harder. So just do what you can do. Now you must be feeling already a stretch. Keep your body up, forward and back. Open your hips. Now, if you want, you can bring your left elbow down, right elbow down, and rest your forehead onto the hand. And push your right knee outward. Like this. It's a very great hip opener. Keep breathing. Gently bring your left knee down and come onto your palms. Now bring the leg in the center and bend your right leg and come to the pigeon. Make sure your both of the hips are equal distance from the floor. And come to your fingertips, push your hips a little forward and look up. Now gently move your hands in the forward and drop your head. Gently bring your hands back. And come, bring your right leg back and come to the downward facing dog. Bring your left leg up and bring it in between of the hands. So we have to do everything on this side now. Drop your right knee on the floor. Bring your hands on the knees and the hips and push your hips forward. And chest open and look up or a little back. Now gently come to the center, open your arms and twist your body towards the left side this time. And come to the center. Now bring your hands to the floor. And bring your left leg outside of the left hand. You can lift your right knee up away from the floor and move your body forward and backward. Keep looking forward, not down. And now drop your right elbow, left elbow, push your right, left leg a little bit outward and rest your forehead onto the floor if you can. Gently come onto your palms and bring your leg in between of the hands and bend your leg. Come to the pigeon pose. Straighten your right leg. Come to your fingertips. Push your hips forward and look up. Now move your hands forward and rest in the sleeping pigeon. Gently bring your hands back and come to the downward facing dog. Walk your dog, bend one knee, another knee, shake your hips, shake your legs, come to your tippy toes, then back to the heels. Relax your legs. Now walk towards your hands. Bend your knees if you need to. We'll do forward fold. Now bring your hands behind your ankle. Pull your navel in and straighten your knees gently and slowly as much as you can. And drop your forehead towards your shin or the knees. Forward fold. Keep breathing here. Breathing in, bring your hands up very gently and slowly. Mindful of your back. And keep your eyes closed. Stand here for a moment. Take few deep breaths in and out and relax. Gently open your eyes. We'll do one more asana, standing asana. It's a balancing plus the hip opener. That's a Garudasana, eagle pose. So bend your knees a little bit. Then your hands on the hips for the balance. Bring your right leg on top of the left and see if you can bring it behind the left calf. If you cannot, that's also fine. Your leg can be like this. And then open your arms. Bring your right hand underneath your left and join the palms together. And see if you can sit down a little bit. That will open the hips more. Just do whatever you can do and smile. Like a flying eagle. Gently come up to the standing. Relax your legs. Relax your hands. Shake your hands, shake your legs. And we'll do on the other side. Bend your knees a little bit. This time lift your right, left leg up. Bring it on the top of the right. And see if you can bring the foot behind the right calf. Open your arms. Now bring your left hand underneath the right this time. And see if you can sit a little lower. And gently come up and relax your legs. How is everybody doing? Good? Tired? Okay, let's sit in a chair. Bring your hands up. Bend your knees a little bit and sit back like you're sitting in a comfortable chair. And down, down, and down. Okay, now sit with your feet little apart and bring your hands in a prayer position. Your feet are little bit diagonal. Your feet are little bit diagonal and little apart, and bring your hands in the prayer position, and your elbows are pushing your knees out. It's called Malasana, but it's a very good hip opener. You can feel like you're opening up your hips and try to sit little straight and look forward. Now you can bring your hands on the floor and then jump back to the plank or walk back. Now jump or walk back to the Malasana. Again, two more times, go to the plank, either walk or jump, whatever is comfortable. Then come to Malasana. One more time, go back to the plank and Malasana. Now let's relax and sit. So we did half lotus. So let's see if we can do full lotus now. We have opened both of the hips. Now let's bring your right leg on top of the left hip. So just do if you can do, okay? I'll give variation people who cannot do. So I'm showing you right now, bring your left leg on top of the right thigh. If you cannot do, just leave it here and bring your other leg on top of the knee, little bit straighter. Not near the hip joint, near the knee, and the other leg is in the bottom. And push the right knee little bit down. So you will feel enough stretch. But others who can do the full lotus, please try full lotus. And sit straight. Now there is one more variation only for the advanced practitioner. Bring your hands on the side, palms facing down. So just observe me first and push your hands down and you come up. It's a Tulasana, balancing pose. But if you're getting just enough stretch here, just stay here. And you can bring your hands up and bend forward. And you will feel you cannot bend forward that much. This, drop your hands and look forward. Have your back straight. Breathing in, bring your hands back and relax your legs. Shake your legs. Now we'll do the other side. Bring the left leg first this time in the half lotus. And I at least cannot do this on this side. My left hip is very tight. So if you cannot do this, bring your leg near the knee. Fold your right leg like this and push your left knee down. You'll feel a very good stretch on your left hip. But others who can do the full lotus on this also, please do it. But just be mindful of your knee or any pain you're feeling. Now bringing both of the hands up and bend forward. Look forward. Breathing in gently, bring your hands back and relax your legs. Now gently lie down on your back for relaxation. Shake your hands if you need to, rock your feet. And lie down on your back. Keep your eyes closed, hands relaxed. Hands on the side of your body, palms facing up. Feet rolling on either side. Full body touching the floor. Take the Mother Earth. Let's take Mother Earth, the weight of your whole body. Completely relax. Take a deep breath in and let it go. Another breath in and relax. Relax your foot, calf muscles, knees, thighs. Relax both of the hips. Relax each and every muscle of the hips. Let go everything. Take a deep breath in and relax more and more. Relax your both of the legs completely. Don't tighten any of the muscles. Let it go. Relax it. Relax your abdomen, chest, shoulders, hands. Relax your facial muscles. Have a smile on your face, even though it is artificial. It relaxes your all the muscles on your face. It's very anti-aging. Relax your forehead, top of the head. Relax your whole body. Whole body. Keep observing your breath. Take deep breaths in and out. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu. Om shanti shanti shanti. Gently bring your awareness back to the body, back to the environment. Wiggle your toes, wiggle your fingers. Bring your hands on the top of your head. Take a full body stretch. And gently turn on your right side. Taking the support of your hands, gently sit up with eyes closed. And take a couple of breaths in and out. Feel the difference in your hip muscles, in your legs, from the time when you started this session and now. Bring your hands in a prayer position, thumb pointing to your sternum, with a feeling of gratitude to your body. Let's rub your palms together, generate some heat, and gently put your palms on your eyes, your face. And whenever you feel complete, you can open your eyes with a broader smile on your face, your cheeks touching your ears. Namaste, and thank you for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed the session. You guys can unmute yourself now.
This was great. Thank you.
Thank you so much. It was so nice.
Did you feel the difference in your hips a little bit?
Yes.
My hips are really tight. I feel the lightness.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you so much.
I will upload this session on YouTube. If you want to practice yourself, then you can just go to my YouTube channel. I think many of you already know, if you came from the group, my YouTube channel, and then you can practice yourself.
Thank you so much.
So there is one thing, if you can stay for 2 minutes. I am starting a 20-day yoga challenge. It will be a paid classes from tomorrow morning. If anybody is a morning or want to make their schedule regular, it will be 5:30 to 6:30, and then it will be 30-minute meditation. It will be Monday to Friday for 4 weeks and 1 day, basically 21-day challenge. So anybody wants to join, you can message me offline. And other thing is, I'm teaching a 4-day yoga workshop next week, Monday to Thursday. That will be 2 hours each day. And you can basically, let me just share the flyer with you. And it will be either in the morning or the evening, depending on how many people join, you know. So if anybody is interested, that is a good way to, you know, bring yoga in your life and make a practice. You can see my screen? Yes?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah. So this will be basically $100, and it's through Art of Living. I will be teaching with another very senior teacher. She has been teaching for 15 years. And this will be 2 hours each day. There will be yoga, there will be knowledge, there will be meditation, pranayama. So it's a very good course, and 14 years plus can attend it. So it's a good time for all the teenagers who are staying at home. You know, I taught this course like a month back, and there were 2 teenager girls, and they still been practicing every day, and they share with me, they see a lot of difference in their flexibility, how do they handle their things, their mind. So I will highly recommend to do this, because after doing this, you will take away 40-minute practice, which you can do at home yourself, you know. Okay. I think somebody was asking me something, and I interrupted, right? So you guys can.
So Seema, is the meditation part the Sky Kriya?
No, so it's not a Sky Kriya. It will be a guided meditation. Sky Kriya is only for the people who has done the course.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
So the guided meditation would be with the Gurudev?
It will be either with the Gurudev, and I can also lead a couple of meditations because I am certified to lead some meditations. But it will, some of the meditation will be Gurudev recorded, and some couple of them I will be also leading. It's every day, 5 days, right? So it will be mixed variety. Yeah. Yeah, because I thought somebody, like I have weekly classes, but those are all in the evening. So some people were demanding for the morning session because they wanted to have their regular schedule in this COVID time. So I thought I'll just put a morning challenge. And if we do the morning challenge continuously, then only you can make it regular. If I just do one or twice, then again, it will not become. So that's why I thought of doing the continuous challenge. And weekends I'm not doing because people want to take a break. So Monday to Friday. So we can, and somebody can relax, right? So that's why. So after, so and that, for that it is $125 all for 21 days basically, and it's 1.5 hour session. Yeah, if you don't want to do the meditation, the meditation is complimentary. So if you don't want to do the meditation, that's fine, you can just stay for the yoga session. So And you all know my style. How do I teach? If you have any questions, you can reach offline to me. And in those sessions, we can put specific requests also, because it's every day. I don't want to repeat things. You know, I want to have a variety of the postures. So if you want to put something like back things or the hip things or anything, we can customize it also. Okay. I hope you are having good days and enjoying. And doing some yoga on yourself, not just when these three sessions are posted. Because doing yoga is, like today I did not do breathing technique, right? Because my session was focused on the hip opener. But in my morning sessions or my weekly classes, some of you are already in my classes. You all know, like I always do some breathing techniques. So we will be doing some pranayams always, because those are very, very important in today's time. So my yoga session format will be 5 minute Q&A. For the any postures which you have any questions from the previous class, because when we do yoga plus meditation, we will not talk after the session, because when you are in a meditative state, you don't want to talk. But in the beginning of the class, in the morning, if anybody has any questions, I'll spend 5 minutes there explaining the postures or anything like that. Then we will have some knowledge for 5 minutes, like what is yoga or some Patanjali Yoga Sutra knowledge or something like that. Then we will have breathing techniques with different pranayams every day. And then we will have the yoga asanas postures, and then the relaxation, and then meditation. So that will be the format for the 21-day yoga challenge.
Thank you.
So think about it. It is starting from tomorrow morning. All right. Anybody has any other questions? I'm here for another 5 minutes. Otherwise, everybody have a very good day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
How did you like
it? Thank you, Seema. It was really wonderful. Thank you. My teenager, she also did the same thing, you know, this yoga sense with me. She really liked. Thank you.
Okay, all right.
Hello?
Yeah. Neha, is it Neha?
Yeah. I wanted to know how I can join your morning session.
So you want to do the challenge, right? 21-day challenge?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so basically the fees there for is $125, and I have a WhatsApp group. So if you are interested, I will add you in the WhatsApp group, and then there will be a Zoom link. I will post it tonight, and then you can join.
Okay, and the payment has to be made through like PayPal?
PayPal. You have PayPal?
Yeah. And what are the timings again?
So it will 5:30 to 6:30 will be yoga, and after that there will be meditation.
Okay. So is there any other time, like other than 5:30, or it's all?
No,
like...
this is the morning challenge. This is a sunrise yoga. Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah. But so if you, I have other classes, but those are weekly class on Sunday.
So like that is only once a week. I have been teaching for last 2 years. But okay. This is, I wanted to do people who want to do yoga really, you know, in the morning and want to do continuously so that they can see that, like if you do 21 days continuously, you will really see the difference in your flexibility. You might see the difference in the weight loss and the strength, right? So that's why so, I just, yeah.
Okay. So will there be like different poses or will there be like this? Because we were in India and we moved here. There I used to do every single day. But mm-hmm. now after, I am out of practice and even there I could never do the Surya Namaskar. I am not that flexible. So I'm okay. just wondering if it is too advanced that I'm not able to do. Like today I was able to do most of it, not as much as you can do, but obviously say 50% to the best of my ability. But I find like, so I just want to know the level of this. Like, is
so
it?
That is the thing in yoga, right? Now because you already have done yoga, so you're not a beginner, that is for sure, right? But yeah. all the other postures, like you said, you could do most of it, but not as deeper as I could do or others could do. And that's perfectly yeah. fine, right? Because yeah. once you do it continuously, you will see the difference, right? So I think you will not have any problems. And if you have any problem in the posture which I'm doing, I can spend some time after the class if you don't understand. Right, but I don't think you will have any problem. Only problem is like sometimes people think, oh, that person can bend so much, but I cannot. And you should not feel bad about it.
Okay, it's the only thing like when you did that, you know, the mull pose and then you went into a plank and then you came back. I just stayed in my position because I can't do that at all. Like I can't
take it. So for that, you know, I myself is taking advanced classes. Okay. So it's okay. not, it came for me, even though my yoga teacher training after that also, I couldn't do that. Okay. So okay. you need practice. So in the beginning, the way you do it, you don't jump back, you walk your legs back.
Okay. In the plank, okay.
Right.
Okay.
And then you walk your legs forward. Once you okay. do that, once you get the idea of that, then you can do that eventually. So I give very options. Like, I don't know, you remember in this posture also, I said, if you cannot jump, you walk back.
Oh yeah.
Right. So I'll just show you when like this, right? We were like this, right? Then you can just walk back in the plank. But when you go into the plank, you're increasing your strength, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
And once you increase your strength, then eventually you can go.
Okay. Okay.
Right? So but the thing is that but if you think, oh, I can't do it, some people are like that, oh, I'm not flexible. I like Seema, you can do so much, I can't do that, and they just don't start yoga, then you cannot reach anywhere, right?
No, that I understand.
Yeah. Okay. So I think as you told, you have been doing yoga, so I don't think you will have any problem. So because it's online, so there are some of the posture like shoulder stand and all, so I just always ask people who have done shoulder stand before, they will do it. Otherwise I don't want new people to start. Because the
you can suggest some easy alternative and then we can just do that.
Yeah, yeah. Like the bridge pose, right? I can say bridge pose. Bridge pose gives yes. the same benefit as the shoulder stand. So I give that alternative, right? So so any posture in which you need little bit supervision, I don't want people to try for the first time online.
Okay. Makes sense.
Yeah. Can you share your YouTube channel, please?
Yes, yes. I will. Let me put this on this chat, okay? So that you can copy paste if you want.
Okay, thank you.
Just so this is my channel.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, this is Neelu, right?
Yes, this is Neelu. Yeah.
So Neelu, you did first time, right? So how did you like it?
I love it, except that I actually am going to work regularly, so my schedule gets really tight, so I don't have the ability to join the class. But I'm going to ask my teenager if she's willing to join, because she's home.
And I do it every weekly classes also, like Sunday evening at 5 o'clock.
Oh, you do?
If you want to join that class, yeah.
Sure. Yeah, so that I can look at, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. All right, great.
All right, thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you. Hi, Neha, do you have any more questions?
Hi, Neha.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Please add me to the group.
The morning challenge?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so I'll send you the... Can you message me your number? Because I won't know, right? You have my number, right?
No, I don't have your number.
Okay, so my number is this.
Wait, let me just save it.
Or yeah, just give me your number. I'll give you a call right now so that I can save your number.
Okay, my number is 650 387 5584.
Okay, so I'm just giving you a call right now.
Okay.
So, and you know, you got the call?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'll add you and I'll send you my PayPal information. Other thing is, I have like three girls who are joining this session and they are friends. So, and they want to do as a buddy, you know, like when you have friends, then you can continue, right, yourself also. So if you have any friends who are interested in, I know you just came from India, but if you have any friends who will be interested, it will be a good idea to do it together. Because it's a good feeling when you know somebody. I mean, you will have a good experience anyways, but if you have friends, then it will be good also.
Yeah, I'll ask my friend right now after the
session. I'll message you the my flyer, like information, what is the, like the link and everything to your WhatsApp so that you can forward, right? And I will upload the video. You can share this channel to your friends also. And they have lots of videos of my classes.
Okay, okay, great.
So Neha, where did you come from in India?
I was in Gurgaon.
Okay, so I'm from Faridabad.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, it's very close. Where are you now?
Los Gatos.
Okay. Yeah, not very far. I'm living in Cupertino right now.
Yes, yes.
Okay, all right, Neha. Nice to meet you. And I'll
Thank you so much for the session. Yeah. Yes, yeah.
And Neha, one more thing. When you send by PayPal, choose the friends option. Otherwise, it takes away some money.
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, some people did it, but it's done now. So that's okay.
Is it? I don't know if you are okay with it. Is it okay if I just attend tomorrow's class and then this make decide, or you want me to decide before tomorrow?
I mean, like you attended my session now, and I have a YouTube channel, so you can see the video.
Ah, yeah, that's good. Right. Yeah, okay, makes sense. Yeah. I'll check out the channel.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Otherwise, everybody will say like that, right? I want some commitment, right? Yeah.
No. I have no doubts on you. I have doubt on myself to wake up early and come for class.
Yeah, so that's why you attend in a group, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. All right. Thank you, Neha.
Thank you. Nice talking. Bye.